Hello, I'm Bosco Rico. This time, I'll show you how I'm shooting videos of planets. Now, this is my telescope, Takahashi Muon 180C. Well, there are various types of telescope. Basically, you can shoot planets with anyone. However, among them, I recommend these telescopes because of their large aperture and compact size. And my telescope is also a kind of this group. Because the optical path is reflected by two mirrors, its tube is very short. And this is my equatorial mount. It's alright even though it is a large mass mount, but the one that can be automatically tracked is best. The telescope I recommend for beginners is like this. The larger the aperture, the brighter and more clearly the image can be taken. So, while it is compact, it is better to choose one with a 5 to 6 inches aperture. Considering price and each of use, I think that starting from this class is the best. Well, as others, I use a barrel lens to extend the focal length and a wedge prism to correct the atmospheric dispersion. Atmospheric dispersion means that the light from space is dispersed by atmosphere depending on each wavelength. And this is offset by this prism. Next, I use a CMOS camera to shoot planets. Although you can use any video camera or mobile phone. Recently, this is a very popular model because it is optimal for the solar system imaging. However, in the case of this camera, a personal computer is required for operation. So I connect it to a mobile PC and control it. Well, this is the operating scene. During shooting, it is my happy night tea time. And this is the completed video. You know, we can post videos taken on YouTube, so we can show it to the whole world. Now, let's show you how to edit as an astrophotography from this video. From now on, I use two free software. One is AutoStackCut 3, the other is Registax 6. First of all, load the video file with AutoStackCut. As you know, the movie is made up of many frames. After analyzing the good or bad of these frames, set the alignment point on one frame. Finally, start stack processing. By doing this, it automatically corrects the position of each frame and stacks these. The resulting is automatically saved as a TIFF file. Next, load this file with the Registax. From here, it will be an amazing process. If you use the function called wavelet, the surface pattern becomes visible from the unclearness image. In this way, I edit an astrophotography of planets. In addition, if you process the image excessively, it looks sharper. But since noise also increases, it would be better to process it moderately. Also, in Japan, there are many images with the south side up. However, from a global perspective, it is often on the north side up. So, you'll apply rotation processing as needed. So, there's no direction in the universe, so we don't need to rotate it at all costs. How did you like it? Why don't we take the planet imaging? That's all for today. Thank you for your watching. See you.